a book about a surgeon who is a woman who has reached her late 30s and is worried that she's maybe given the best years of her life to her career. And it's a very sexist industry to work in. But she finally finds someone that she's fallen in love with when she thinks she might never meet a husband. Within 6 months of meeting this man, they get married. And within 6 months of getting married, he's dead. And the question is, did she kill him? And did he deserve it? So it's a book about when you meet someone and you fall in love very quickly, do you lie to yourself? Do you ignore their faults? Do you tell yourself that they are the perfect partner for you? And do you ignore the danger? Because human beings are very, very good at ignoring danger when there is something they want. You know, we ignore our own fears because we want to believe everything's going to be okay, especially in a relationship. So it's about how the most dangerous lies are the lies we tell ourselves. It's a book very much about the sexism in medicine and about the double standards, about how you're a surgeon and you're a man, if you are bad-tempered and you shout, people say he's very strong-minded, you know, he doesn't suffer fools gladly, but if you're a woman, they say she's a bitch, or they say, oh, she must have her period. It's a book about that double standard, about how she is someone who's very strong and powerful, but the question is, if she's that strong and powerful, is she capable of killing her husband? Because my wife worked as an anaesthetist for a long time, and she worked with a lot of surgeons. And we always asked, to be a surgeon, you have to be prepared to cut people open. Human beings have an aversion to cutting people open. We wondered, to be a surgeon, do you learn to overcome that resistance, or is it not there in your head in the first place? Is the surgeon a psychopath? So the book is about that. Is the surgeon a psychopath? Is she a psychopath? Or is she the victim? I grew up on books like William McIlvany, who really invented the Scottish crime novel. And it was a big boost to me to read something that was set in my city that was exciting. And it was the excitement of American crime fiction, because a lot of the English crime fiction was a very middle class. It was all about murder in small villages, and it didn't address society. And Scottish crime fiction, starting off with McIlvany, then writers like Ian Rankin, Val McDermid, these were people who wrote about society. They wrote about murder as a symptom that something is wrong in society. And we just seem to have a lot of crime writers in Scotland. I think people who are interested in reading and writing in Scotland are going to be reading crime. And so when they think, I'd like to write, they start thinking about crime stories, because that's the type of book they write. So the more good crime writing there is in Scotland, the more good crime writers there will be in the future. We just keep producing different types of crime writers here, which there's a great wealth of crime writers. We have historical crime fiction. We have crime fiction that's based in the darkest of poverty, and we have crime fiction in the middle classes. I think we reflect the diversity of society in our crime fiction, but also we are good friends. We like to get together. We have a fantastic festival in Scotland, in Stirling every September, called Bloody Scotland, where all the crime writers get together, and we talk about our books, but we also play football. We have a Scotland versus England five-a-side crime writers match. We have quizzes, we play music. So I think, most importantly, the crime writers in Scotland, we don't take ourselves too seriously. We take our work seriously, but we like to have fun, because reading crime fiction is about enjoying yourself. I think in Scotland we are very direct in the way we talk about things. We have an expression in Glasgow to say, he didn't miss and hit the wall, meaning that someone was very direct and they really got something, you know, they weren't subtle. And in Scotland, we like to address our social issues. So I think our writing reflects that if we have problems in society, we want to talk about them. We want to put them at the heart of our fiction. So we don't write polite novels. You know, we tend to... I had a professor who once defined the difference between Scottish comedy and English comedy. He said that English comedy is the comedy of manners and Scottish comedy is the comedy of bad manners. You know, that we... The English comedy has been afraid of saying the wrong thing, and the Scottish comedy is of enjoying saying the wrong thing. And I think our crime fiction reflects that we do like to address issues of society head on. We like to be direct about it. And crime fiction is a good genre for that, because if someone has died, then that's a great symptom that something is wrong in a society. And so it's the ideal way to explore what might be wrong in a society rather than pretend everything is okay.